ಸ್ತುಮಯಿತೆ ಬಹೂತಿ ದೈವ್ಯಾ ಹೋತಾ ರಾಮ ನಿಶಂತ ಪೂರ್ವೇರಿಷ್ಟಾ ಸ್ಯಾಮ ಸುವೀರಾ ಮಹ್ಯಂ ಜಯಂತು ಮಮ ಯಾನಿ ಹವ್ಯಾ ಭೂತಿ ಸತ್ಯ ಮನಸೋ ಮೇ ಅಸ್ತು ಏನೋ ಮಾನಿಗಾಂ ಕಥಮಜ್ಜನಾಂ ನಿಷ್ಠೆ ದೇವಾಸೋ ಅಧಿಬೋಧದಾಮಿ ಮಹಿ ಪ್ರಜಾ ಮಾತನೋಷತೆ ಸೋಮರಾಜ ಅಗ್ನಿಮ್ಯಂ ಪ್ರತಿ ಹೃದಂ ಪುರಸ್ತಾದಬ್ಧೋ ಗೋಪಾ ಪರಿಪಾಹಿನಸ್ತ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಂಚೋಯಂತು ನಿಬುಧ ಪುನಸ್ತೆ ಮೈಷಾ ಚಿತ್ತ ಪ್ರಬುಧ ಜಸ್ಪತಿರ್ದೇವಂಸವಿತಾರಮಿಮಾತಿಶಾಹಿಮಸ್ತಿ ನೋ ವಾ ಬೃಹಸ್ಪತಿರ್ದೇವಾಹ್ವಾಜಾನೋ ಮಹಿಷಶ್ಚರ್ಮಜಗೂಸದಸ್ಮಿನ್ಹೇ ಪುರುಹೂತಃ ಪುರುಕ್ಷು ಸ ನಃ ಪ್ರಜಾರೀಹೈಯಶ್ಚ ಮೃಡದೇ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾನೋರೀರಿಶೋ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಮೇಧಾದೇವಿ ವಾಗ್ದೇವಿ ಮಹಾಗಣಪತಿ ವಿದ್ಯಾಗಣಪತಿ ಅನುಗ್ರಹ ಸಿದ್ಧಿರಸ್ತು ಸರ್ವೇಷಾಂ ಓಂ ಪ್ರಣೋ ನ ಪ್ರಣೋ ದೇವಿ ದೇವಿ ನ ಪ್ರಣೋ ದೇವಿ ನೋ ದೇವಿ ದೇವಿ ನೋ ನೋ ದೇವಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ದೇವಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ದೇವಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ದೇವಿ ದೇವಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ವಾಜೇ ಭಿರ್ವಾಜೇ ಭಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ದೇವಿ ದೇವಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ವಾಜೇ ಭೀ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ವಾಜೇ ಭಿರ್ವಾಜೇ ಭಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ವಾಜೇ ಭಿರ್ವಾಜಿನೀವತಿ ವಾಜೇ ಭಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ವಾಜೇ ಭಿರ್ವಾಜಿನೀವತಿ ವಾಜೇ ಭಿರ್ವಾಜಿನೀವತಿ ವಾಜಿನೀವತಿ ವಾಜೇ ಭಿರ್ವಾಜೇ ಭಿರ್ವಾಜಿನೀವತಿ ವಾಜಿನಿ ಪತೀತಿ ವಾಜಿನೀಪತಿ ಧೀನಾಮ ವಿತ್ತಿಯ ವಿತ್ತಿ ಧೀನಾಂ ಧೀನಾಮ ವಿತ್ತಿಯ ವತ್ತವತ್ತ ವಿತ್ತಿ ಧೀನಾಂ ಅವಿತ್ತಿಯ ವತ್ತವತ್ತ ವಿತ್ತಿಯ ವಿತ್ತವದು ಅವತ್ತಿತ್ಯವದು
ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ಐ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಎ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಐ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸರೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಲಾಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಡ್ರೀಮರ್ಸ್. We have a Malabadi from up to high school and Sampada that crosses like, you know, beyond high school and college. Why we have not done something in this country to have something with a soul of Indianness, the Bharatiyata, the university, the Vishwavidyalayam, that word, that concept is given to the world by India. By the Bharatiya scholars, the Nalanda Vishwavidyalayam, in the 8th century onwards, like, you know, all these universities, people from different parts of the world came by walk to these universities, discussed, debated. They were the kaleidoscope of perspectives of different nationalities and cultures. The Jagadguru, India played a Jagadguru role. Over the centuries, we lost that championship. We lost that leadership role. Somewhere a new beginning has to be made. That was about 5 years ago. Me and Rajgaru sitting at a dining table in my home, thought of starting a university. I said, SiliconAndhra University. Rajgaru, with his immediate spontaneity, said, let's call it University of SiliconAndhra, USA or UofSA. An idea was born. We didn't realize what it takes to start the university. We started digging into it. In this country, to start a university is an extensively challenging and elaborate process. But nothing ever scares us. We initiated the process. We worked on it. We formed a small group of people to focus on bringing the University of SiliconAndhra dream alive. In 2016, there are several other organizations who tried to get the BBP approval ahead of us, couldn't get it. But because of the track record of the SiliconAndhra, BBP gave the approval around the Ugadi time in 2016. As soon as we got the approval, I told you, everybody is a dreamer. Rajgaru, Dilbagaru wanted to have our own building. And come the University of SiliconAndhra approval, we did the Gruha Pravesham on October 2nd at 6:50 a.m. into the Dr. Lakireddy Hanumireddy Bhavan, with Dr. Hanumireddy Garu being the grand benefactor, coming out and donating $1 million. You dream, people will be there to make them realize. BPP initially said, we will give you to start two programs. So we picked Carnatic music and Kuchipudi dance. After the October 2nd Gruha Pravesham, from the spring of 2017, we started the classes. The masters, the diploma, the certificate in Kuchipudi dance and Carnatic music. What a journey it is. Beyond any one of our imaginations, any one of us means the administrative team, the faculty, the students, none of us really know what we are getting into. But we have a dream and we want to fulfill that. How could we make something with the inspiration of Nalanda kind of Viswavidyalayas to provide a world-class curriculum and really challenge our students and faculty? But we are in the 21st century. The learning should be of the 21st century quality. Whatever the best of the universities implement, we have taken those tools. The learning management system, student information systems, they all cost hundreds of thousands of dollars. We know what the challenges we have, we had, we will have. But not worried, because we are confident of creating a brilliant future with the soul of India. What is soul of India? Soul of India is, the world is one family, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. They never said one religion or one sect or one caste or one creed to be happy. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. So when you say Indianness at soul, that is what the Jagadguru position it attained. University of SiliconAndhra again would like to take that leadership role in providing with the soul of that Indianness, Bharatiyata. Do you think we are going to have only fine arts or languages? No. This would be a university that would have all the departments. But everything, how could we do something with that same spirit of India? We all have a dream. I would continuously see myself, University of SiliconAndhra, in the near future, going to have a campus. You would be entering onto the main Aryabhatta Boulevard, making a right turn to go to Andhra Chagaraja Avenue for the Annamacharya Performing Arts Center. You may be making a roundabout. There may be Siddhendra Yogi Street, where you would be listening to the gungurus, the bells. It could be Kuchipudi, it could be Bharatanatyam, it could be Odissi, it could be Manipuri. This would be the place. Whether it is Karnataka or Hindustani, this would be the place. Whether it would be the folk of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, or Sugam Sangeeta of Marathi, this would be the place. All the languages, this would be the place. And we don't stop. Languages, today we are in the digital world. The whole world is in our hands. We are going to have computational linguistics. We are going to have medical school. We are going to have, you name it, we will have all the departments. Having all education is not fun. Our Rajgaru dreams that we will have our own football team, we will have our own cricket team. Maybe in the next 3-4 presidential elections later, our campus could be a venue for the US presidential debate. Let's dream big. Let's dream big. But we wake up and make our dreams come true. The students who went through the experimental beginning, initial phases of this university, every one of us faced the challenges. Today we are here. This is a monumental historic day. As I said, if we could take Kuchipudi to a 45,000 people stadium, you will be witnessing, you will be walking with your kids and grandkids in the near future to enter into a stadium full of graduation ceremony. Trust me, you will see it, and I assure you that on behalf of the Board of Regents and the faculty and the President's office. But we need to work for it. We need to reach out. The same dream need to be transmitted from me to you two to others. It should be, the enthusiasm should be the contagious. Because then the life would feel very blissful. You might have heard, for almost 70 years, Indians are migrating to this country. People came under the boats. We are a highly successful community. After Jewish community, we are the most successful academically, professionally. You know what? We have done everything in this country. We have beauty salons. We have barbershops. We have barbershops. We have billionaire organizations set up by our people. But somehow, people left us an opportunity for SiliconAndhra family to start University of SiliconAndhra, to create a world-class firm. This is the beginning of a new journey. For the master's students, hope you will come back to do the PhD in the near future. For those diploma and certificates, you will go to the master's. And we started with the 2 departments. Today we have added Bharatanatyam. And from this semester, we'll be adding Department of Telugu and Department of Sanskrit. The heights we are going to scale, there is no limit. People say sky is the limit. I don't believe. There is more than beyond the sky. Let's reach out. Let all your dreams come true. And let the spirit of unity across the world continue. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Good morning, everybody. I'm very happy and very proud to be here today. We come from a great country, India. India is a great country with so many people, with so much maturity. And we came to a very, very, very great country, this country of opportunity. As you all know, in this country, in America, if you are honest, you work hard, sky is the limit. Look at this guy, the Tesla man, Elon Musk. He just came 20 few years ago to America. And I'm sure you know, 110 years ago, Henry Ford came up with the Ford car and Elon Musk came with the Tesla car. He was not born in America. The greatness of America is anybody, if you work hard, you are smart, this is the place to grow. So, the Anand Garu came up with a amazingly a dream. I don't know what else, what more he has in his pockets. Some more dreams. 15 years ago, I never thought he will come up with something like this. And the same way, so many people started so many organizations. Indian people first started Tana, Ata, Nata, Bata. So many things were started, but this is something special. It's a dream child of Anand and his family of SiliconAndhra people. And you're all part of it. I'm really proud of you all. And the greatness of this is all other organizations, today there is one, tomorrow there are two, day after tomorrow there are four. But in SiliconAndhra, still people respect each other, they stick together. And please, Rajgaru, Dhirbabu and all of you, please keep yourself together and keep going and sky is the limit for you. I'm really proud of you and it's wonderful. There is place for everybody. There is place. You see, in a class, everybody can get first class. Everybody can get 100% marks. There is no limit. Only in the games and politics, only one will win. But we are not in games, we are not in politics. So, the greatness of this is, today Anand is with this university. Tomorrow God knows what else he has in his pocket. He will come up with some other new idea. And Anand Garu, I really thank you. You come up with beautiful ideas and with your unlimited ambition and energy, you really going. And I pray the God to help you and the entire family. I'm very proud. I'm really thankful to all of you for giving me this opportunity to speak here. Thank you.
Dear Chairman and Regents, faculty, students, hearty congratulations to all the graduates. This must be a really special, special moment for you and also parents and other people. Life goes on like a video. Most of the time, it's like a movie. We are playing a role, we are observing, whether we are on the stage or off the stage. Only after the fact, we look at and see what were the critical moments. For all of you graduates, this is one of those flash moments, a photograph that you can remember for a very long time in the long life of video that you have. And at this particular time, I'm really proud to be a Telugu person, a Indian person, because I grew up with a certain feeling that several times Andhra people are what you call, we are very well known for what is called Arambha Suratvam. We start a lot, we talk a lot, we really start big, but we never finish anything. SiliconAndhra has done extraordinary job of showing that the 21st century Telugu people, 21st century Indians are not about talking big but doing nothing. This is a proof, and you are the proof that we can actually take up anything, we can create a process, we have wonderful people to support, we have wonderful way in which we can make something happen. Within 3 years of envisioning, we're actually sitting and graduating that is a memorable moment, not only in our lives, but in the entire, what you might call Andhra Pradesh, Telangana. If you look at all of them, this is a very, very proud moment. And I congratulate each one of you to really celebrate this. This is like nothing ever felt. This changes the history of Telugu people, that when SiliconAndhra thinks, when we want to do something, we can achieve it. So that is another important moment. As we think about moments of life, I wanted to reflect on three moments of my own life. The first moment I realized was that intelligence was not enough. I never used to prepare for my classes or exams, 10th class, intermediate. I just went in, I listened to what they said, and I tried to do my best. Everybody expected me to be a genius. Everybody expected me to do extraordinarily well. When I passed out from my 12th class, which we used to call intermediate, all my friends got first class. I ended up with third class. Actually, I looked up in first class. I looked up in second class. I looked up in third class, and then there I was. Everybody were laughing at me, saying, wait a minute, we all thought you are a great genius. Now we have find out that you are like a zero. On that day, I realized the intelligence is great, but if you don't put in the hard work and the effort day in and day out to actually use that intelligence, you will never amount to anything. That was a moment for the first time I began to pay attention to education. But unfortunately, when I went to college, I couldn't get into engineering, which is what I wanted to do. In any college, I couldn't even enter. I couldn't get into English medium, and ours was the first Telugu medium. Of course, now I'm on reflection, I'm proud that I was the first Telugu medium student, but at that time, I can tell you, I was pretty ashamed that I was sitting in with people who could not get into any other subject, any other class. But for the first time, I was beginning to pay attention to what's going on. I was conscious of various things that were around and inside and how much hard work it took. And that realization allowed me to really do extraordinarily well later. But the first and foremost is, it doesn't matter what you have done, it doesn't matter how smart you are, you need to really begin to pay attention to what needs to be done every step of the way if you want to really become successful. That became an important lesson. The second moment was, I somehow did very well in my BSc, MSc. I got into IIT for my PhD, and I was actually finishing up a PhD, and then there was a great opportunity, and I had a lot of interaction with a Nobel laureate called John Bardeen. And then there was an opportunity where he invited me to come and work at University of Illinois. And it was a phenomenal thing, except that somehow some accident was there in my lab. I lost all my crystals, and I ended up spending another year and a half and lose the opportunity to work with this extraordinary person. And I came to University of Utah, and my professor and myself, we didn't get along. Every day, I felt like I needed to go back. I applied for 170 jobs, didn't get a single one of them in 1981. I began to realize maybe the best thing is for me to go back to India. I was at University of Utah, I went to Salt Lake City Mall to buy some stuff to take it to India. As I went there was an Indian who had a store, like Indian, what you might call memorabilia kind of stuff. One Narayan Singh, Dr. Narayan Singh. He invited me to a party. I went to his party, and then he said, oh, you are a physicist. We are looking for physicists in radiobiology lab. I didn't know what that moment meant. I went next day to that department. Oh, what do you have your PhD in? I have a PhD in optical information storage. He said, no, we are doing something in Hiroshima, Nagasaki, radiation dose assessment. Interestingly, I realized that was gone. So I was looking at, you know, next 10, 15 minutes anyway, he was showing me the laboratory. Interestingly, as he was showing the laboratory, I had an interesting moment. Like, actually, Prasad Nalamudu Garu is sitting here. His wife, Sucheta, was my senior. She did her PhD with the same advisor I did, with Professor Vaividya Smurthy. And she had some leftover equipment. Somebody from University of Hyderabad came in to do some experiments. I ended up working with him and I published a couple of papers. I remembered some of it. And this guy in University of Utah in radiobiology, that is exactly what they were using. He said, oh, you know about thermoluminescence? I said, yeah, I have a couple of papers. Next thing I know, I have a job. So the key part is, I realized that it doesn't matter how much you prepare. You need to be open to opportunities, especially all of you are graduating. If you may have your career plans, you may have your design on what you want to do, what dance school, what Carnatic music classes that you want to run. Be prepared to be surprised. Be open to moments where you have no idea where the help is going to come from. Don't ever shut down opportunities. Don't ever become pessimistic. And don't ever think that it is not possible. You are sitting in as a graduate of University of SiliconAndhra. Anand Garu and the entire SiliconAndhra, what it has done is proven that when you make a proper sankalpa, when you are really committed to see it through, as they said, you know, Jnana Shakti and then Kriya Shakti will come as soon as you put your energy behind your sankalpa and never say, I give up, it is done. And the last moment that became extremely important was from University of Utah, somehow I had an, what you call, interest in computers, got into a big fight with Steve Jobs the first day I met in University of Utah, but I ended up in Apple. I was a fellow at Apple, looking at future directions, and we were researching on how people learn, how people design and think. Ended up interviewing 17 Nobel laureates. My head was swelling with arrogance and pride. I had just spent so much of time in the operating theaters of brain surgeons. I go to India with, you know, so much of pride that I'm a fellow at Apple, Apple University. I'm coming in, like, everybody should respect me. I went to a conference called Business of Business is Learning. This is 1989. Just before that, there was an Israeli, he told me, you got all this American stuff, but you know what I'm doing with autism and some of the children? It's actually coming from one simple principle from Patanjali Yoga Sutras. Do you know that? I said, yeah, yeah. I recited the mantra and I recited the particular sutra. I told him where it is from and I explained it to him. He said, oh, now you know what I have done with 50,000 autism people. I said, huh? Well, he said, you know the words, but you don't know the meaning. You are an Indian only in color, but it looks like you have become a proud American. You have forgotten your roots. That was something very hard for me to take. Then I went to Bulgaria. I found the same thing. The accelerated learning experts, Lazanov and Barzakho, they told me all what we use is something from dance, kalaripattu, music, and the idea of how to express oneself. What we call immersion learning is something we took from Bharatanatyam, Kathakali, Kuchipudi, because your bhavana and your expressions, how you do, without even opening your mouth, how you can tell an entire story through your dance, that is something that we have incorporated into language learning, immersion language learning. Unfortunately, there are not that many people who can interpret what you do in India. So most of us are so busy, either we are doing pure whatever we are doing, but we don't know how to apply it to the context, or we are doing the Western stuff, thinking that Indian stuff is not there. And I realized I was one of them myself. What they call a coconut, brown skin, white mind. I think that was the turning point for me for the first time when they told me, you know all about the brain. You learned all about the cerebellum and medulla oblongata and the frontal cortex. But do you know anything about pineal gland, pituitary gland? We talk about in yoga and the Ajna Chakra. We talk about the Vishuddha. We talk about the Sahasrara. And they are connected with some of them. Do you know anything about them? Have you learned about Kundalini Chakra? I said, oh, I spent 20 years learning Sanskritam when I was growing up. But do you use any of that stuff? I didn't have any answer. I realized I know a lot of words. I know a lot of things. I remembered in Chandogya Upanishad how Narada goes to Sanat Kumara and says, sir, I know all the things, Veda, Vedanga, all of them, but I'm not happy. I don't know the nature of myself. Similarly, for the first time, I realized 30 years ago, what I needed to do was to re-own my Indianness, re-own my humanity of my own roots. This is the fatherland, that is the motherland. Only when I can integrate what I am and who I am with what I do, things work, which is what actually I have been doing for the past 28 years, integrating the Indian wisdom, the Vedic wisdom with the Western management and brain research. So, what I can recommend to you as graduates is that who you are is much bigger than the color of your skin, the language you speak, and the accent that you have, the money you have. But who you are as the spirit that comes from eternal time, like whenever you are happy, like Anando Brahme Divya Janat, Anandatyeva Kalvimani Bhutani Jayanti, Anandena Jatani Jivanti. This is called Bhatavidya, like to Varnavidya. The idea is when you are happy, when you integrate your Indianness and Americanness, when you take your Shakti and connect it to, you know, that is the consciousness with your intelligence, that is Shiva. The Shiva is Prakasha and Shakti is the Vimarsha. When you reflect your light in your own energy, then there is nothing to stop. Today, as graduates, you have learned the music and you have learned the dance, which is about the emotion and the body language. How do you communicate? How your expressions can be a lot more. Hopefully, these expressions that you have learned will spread not only from your body and your heart, you bring it to your intellect and the spirit of who you are, the spirit of SiliconAndhra, spirit of the Indian wisdom, spirit of the Carnatic music and the dance that you have learned. May that spirit flow through all your life and wherever you go, whomever you touch, whatever you do, let that energy multiply and let that light of your own wisdom shine and make you and the world a brighter place. All the best and congratulations 2019 SiliconAndhra.
I came to this country to pursue my graduate program and I received my master's degree from Miami University. Later on I attended several friends' graduation ceremonies and family members' graduation ceremonies. I feel very fortunate, never ever imagined in my life I would be conferring upon a class of graduates. I thank God, I thank my family, and I thank the entire SiliconAndhra family and the community for being able to stand in front of you here to confer the degrees on the graduating class. May I request all the grad students to rise. I, on the board of regents of the University of SiliconAndhra, recommendation of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in them by the state of California, hereby confer upon the degree of Master of Arts and the Diploma and Certificate with all the rights, privileges and honors thereto pertaining, given at Milpitas in the state of California on the 27th day of January 2019. Hearty congratulations to all the graduates. Please be seated.
After 2 years of your hard work, your commitment to higher learning, and the sacrifices you made, and today, the result of all that hard work, today it represents the culmination of your academic achievement. It's a time of celebration, and it's a reflection for each and every one of you, the pioneering class of University of SiliconAndhra, and you have these bragging rights for the rest of your life and for the, you know, for the future that's we there. You are the first batch of University of SiliconAndhra. Ladies and gentlemen, this first batch, the pioneering batch, we have some teenagers here, youth, moms, and some grandparents. It's a wonderful feeling. This is what SiliconAndhra is about. It's a platform for everyone. It's a platform for everyone. And today, you are in the history. You are in the history as the first batch. And that nobody will be able to take it away from you. You earned it. Congratulations. The confidence you gained here, the knowledge from our amazing faculty, our faculty is second to none. You can take that to the bank. Any time in your life, you are looking for some support, some confidence, look back for these 2 years that you spent at University of SiliconAndhra. It will give you the immense strength. I don't think there will be any problem that will be coming across your way that you cannot overcome. I want to congratulate you on behalf of everybody and request you, as you are the ambassadors of this university, please take everything that you gained, everything that you learned here with great pride. Take it to everybody that you know. Help them. Bring them to this university. Let us continue to create the history. Thank you. So now, the moment that we have all been waiting for. So this is the order in which we will go. We will start with certificate students in Carnatic music, followed by Kuchipudi dance. Then we will go to the diploma students, and finally, the Masters of Arts students. I would request Dr. Hanumareddy garu to please go to the front, sir, with Anand garu. To begin with, certificate in Carnatic music. Swati Dharma. Swati Dharma. Srivalli Ramabandi. Srivalli Garu is from South Africa. Now we will go to diploma students to start with Carnatic music. Anusha Goda. We will move to Kuchipudi dance. Diploma students, Pranavi Chamarthi. Jari Kundu Batla. Anusha Kuchi Batla. Kuchipudi. Satya Priya Tanula. Gita Kandi. Ratnamala Vanka. Snehalata Vedula. Yeah. Pravallika Vemuri. Pravallika is from Canada. Now we will move to the Master of Arts students, Kuchipudi department. Lakshmi Babu. Bhagyashree Benna Bhaktula. Aruna Chandra. Jyoti Chindalapudi. She is also our Vice President of Kuchipudi Department in the Global SiliconAndhra. Sridevi Dadi Tota. Shruti Veeravalli Dubbaka. Swati Gundapuniri. Aparna Nadella. Sarada Nori. Kanish Polavarapu. Srilata Suri. Srivani Vokarane. That is the pioneering class of the University of SiliconAndhra. Congratulations and best wishes. Thank you.
May I request all the graduating class to rise, please. Now you have the bragging rights of the pioneer class of stuff. Please turn your tassel from right to left. Give a big hand to the class of 2019. this moment, University of SiliconAndhra Alumni Association forms, and you are all bestowed the alumni status, and congratulations. I request all the graduating class to stay after the ceremony for pictures that will be forever preserved for the future and the history. There, Baba.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Before we close today's ceremony, I would like to take the last opportunity to say, on behalf of Board of Regents, President's Office, and the faculty and staff of University of SiliconAndhra, congratulations. Congratulations to both the graduates, family, and friends who have helped us arrive at this moment. The University of SiliconAndhra's mission is dedicated to the discovery, development, communication, and application of knowledge in a wide range of academic and artistic fields. Its mission of providing the highest quality academic programs is inseparable from its mission of developing new understandings of ancient Indian arts, languages, and culture through research and creativity. Our graduates, your outstanding achievements have lightened this room. Despite living in various parts of the world, you have took the initiative to stay connected to your roots and master the Indian classical arts, and that is something to be very proud of. These achievements do not end at the receiving of certificates and diplomas, followed by hanging them on the wall for people to admire. So, exactly what does this day mean? What this day means is not the highlight of great applause for receiving this degree, but rather accentuating the dedication and passion on how far you set your limits. Just think about all that brought us here, all the late and tiring nights to attend class, all the grades, all the classroom experiences, all the efforts, all the teaching and learning, all of it, it all comes together here today in this ceremony. The tassels are on the left side now, signifying graduation. As this delightful journey has come to an end, another awaits with many more opportunities, challenges, and pursuits. There will come a time where the knowledge you learn will be applied, and that time is now. As you move on to the next level, kindly embody the ideas that we implanted and show the world your individuality with your gratification. Nevertheless, adversities are not an exception to the rule of having success. But despite of that, don't forget to hold on to your passion. For the art to continue your learning journey, be a lifelong learner. You have paved the path for future alumni. To conclude, University of SiliconAndhra proudly presents its inaugural graduating class. Congratulations once again. Thank you.
The recessional track starts. Again, the Grand Marshal Rajgar leads the Board of Regents and the faculty, followed by the students. We will go down this way and go into the main hall. And I request all the audience to stay until the recession is completed. Please play the recession track. I request the graduates to be in their robes, because we would like to have pictures on the stage
with the alumni of the thing, with the faculty and all. You could take pictures with your family and all before you change into your regular dress. Let us spend some time to have some good memories, because your family will be waiting for your pictures. Now, let's complete the ceremony with the recitation. Rajgar. And to celebrate this occasion, we have a small sweet for you to share. So pick up your sweet right on the way. Thank you. Thank you very much.